at Full Sail Brewing. It's right in front of me here. I'm going to head in and see what the cuisine internship is all about.
This is their brew board, which tells them what's in each of their 23 fermenters and what they'll be brewing this week. Just to the right of it is the brew deck, where all the magic happens. The day I was there, a grain shipment came in. I got to go out on top of the truck and help get the grain checked in. We took a taste of the grain just to see what it was like before we checked it in. From there, it was transferred from the truck into the outside holding bins. When it's needed for the brew, it's transferred by air from the outside into the weighing bin seen here. Once it's all weighed out according to the recipe, the brewer hits the button and the grains move from the weighing bin over to the mill, where it's crushed and then moved by air over to a grist tank in the brew house. The grist tank holds it until it's needed for the brew. When the mash tun is finally at the right temperature, it moves up this blue conveyor belt where it drops into the mash tun. This particular batch was the IPA, so we were mashing in at 156 degrees. The brewer uses the computer on the brew deck to adjust the temperature on the steam jacket. However, the water that's hydrating the grain going into the mash tun is adjusted by using these hot and cold levers. Once it moves from the mash tun over to the louder tun, they vorloft and start to move the wort over into the kettle. Here, you can see the wort flowing into the kettle, as well as the steam jacket that's used to heat up the wort. It takes about 2.5 hours of sparging to fill the kettle with about 7,000 gallons of wort. They bring it up to a boil, and they use this China hat to make sure to keep the boil rolling. They use a computer to monitor the temperatures and the time that the ingredients need to be added along the way. Here, you can see me adding the finishing hops to the IPA we were brewing that day. I added about 260 pounds of pelletized hops into the boil. They wouldn't give me the recipe, but I did see that we were adding Summits, Centennials, and Cascades as the finishing hops in the IPA. When the boil's finally finished, the worts move from the kettle down into the whirlpool, which is located just below the kettle. Here, you can see a larger view of what the brew deck looks like from down below. Here's what about 600 pounds of hops looks like when it's finished in the whirlpool. After the whirlpool, it moves through this heat exchanger, which is actually about the size of a car. It's transferred down here, into the cellar, and into one of these fermentation tanks located down here. Full Sail, as I mentioned, has about 23 fermentation tanks, both inside and outside of their building. These are glycol-cooled fermentation tanks. This tank here is actually the yeast mixer, where we mixed up about 1,500 pounds of yeast for the IPA that we were moving over. Here, you can see three other tanks, which hold about 60 barrels of yeast for future batches. Full Sail has several different size fermenters, anywhere from 500 barrels to about 800 barrels. They said that they had just purchased 4 800-barrel fermenters to go outside of their building at a cost of about $1 million last year. This increased their output to about 200,000 barrels each year. Once fermentation is complete, the beer moves through this complex series of pipes and through a hard particle filter, which filters out most of the leaf hops that might go through. They tell me that when they do the IPA, they have to stop and empty this filter about 3 or 4 times. They also have an extremely large keg cooler and hop storage area. In here, you can see where they keep their kegs cold for the restaurant upstairs, as well as the rest of the kegs before shipping. On the shelves, you can see the huge number of pallets of hops that they keep on hand, as well as some of the vintage beers. Here, they keep a sample of every single bottle that comes off the line for at least 6 months. They also have some barrels that they're keeping cold as well as some vintage beers for different beer festivals. Full Sail also has a lab on site, which staffs 3 people, where they measure everything from oxygen in the beer to how it ages in the bottle. Here you can see where they measure bacteria and samples of wort. They also have some very cool machines. This is called the Beeralyzer. You put in a few drops of beer, and it measures everything from alcohol content to IBUs. It was a wonderful 2 days brewing in Hood River.